Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopal Jaya Jaya.
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopal Jaya Jaya.
Thank you. ఇచ్చా భక్తులు పతితానం నమో మహావదన్నాయ కృష్ణ కృష్ణాయ
honor them
and not other, then he is not even Vaishnava. His platform even is not Vaishnava platform. It is out of any Vaishnava. We should reject him. But if Dikshasti Cheta, he has taken Diksha, initiation, and really he has some relation with Krishna. All truths, conclusions, all kinds of Krishna Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Maya Tattva, Jiva Tattva, all he has gained. This is Divya Kyan. And also he has got a relation from his Guru, a very thick relation, a special relation. Not only that he is at a low servant of servant. Only a special among five he has realized this by his Gurudev. And all kinds of sin, bad activities, unwanted things, anarth, aparad has been gone away. If this Vaishnava is like this, having diksha, not only by your Gurudev, anywhere he has got Vaishnavi diksha. Anywhere. We must honor, because now he is a Vaishnava. And if you are not honoring them, proper giving respect according to their
ability
and the stage of Vaishnava, then you are not Vaishnava. And if you are envious to them, then what is it? You are not giving proper respect even to your God brothers. But those who are senior, who are surely a very sincere and senior devotee, we must respect. This is first thing. This is the platform of Vaishnava. So we must follow all this. If you are not following, you are confined in a only box. What box? Oh, he is not my Gurudev, God brother. He is not initiated by one of our God brothers. Dikshasti Cheta. Like, you should know that even a Mayavadi sannyasi or anyone comes to your house or temple or anything, and if he is hungry, the first should be done. If he is coming, without invitation he is coming. What should we do? We should reject him. Oh, go like one? Never. Once it became so, at the time of Prabhupada Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sukhasati, any Mayavadi came in the temple at Chandrasekhar Bhavan, Mayapur, Govindama, and they were not proper giving respect. That he is Atithi, not as a Mayavadi or Vaishnava. Only
as a guest.
As a guest. And he wanted to take some prasad, but they refused to. And Prabhupada became very
angry.
Very, what do you know?
Furious.
Stern.
And he called them and he chastised them. And here, again, when something, oh, you should come here and take prasad. And by this sweet behavior, that Mayavadi even that light on the Jyotish of Srila Prabhupada. And he has so much regard for it. So what to Vaishnava? If Vaishnava comes, no. I want to take water. Oh, that water tap is there. Oh, we have some rest. I know Swamiji very well, more than anyone in this world. And I know him from when? 46 and when there was no birth of even ISKCON, no ISKCON, anything. I know from beginning. And I have thought so much. We have discussed so many things, like friendly terms or each other cutting arguments. And cooking for him, giving my chadar for his bed. So much service I have. How he was polite, how I was broad-minded. And that is he came and he became successful. He took in his lap whole world. He was, his heart was so generous and so good. Otherwise, if he was of this, that, oh, my only guru brothers, oh, I can give respect. How he can? Then in a very couple of years, he preached to her whole world. So we must try to respect and to follow the teachings of Srila Rupa Goswami. And then third word, oh, you know that Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, in his main mat, in Chandrasekhar Bhavan, Gaurya Mat, Mayapur, in the temple, he has in the four corners, four acharyas, Madhva, Ramanu, Vishnu, Swami, Bhagavan. He has wife. We should respect all boys. And if this time anywhere in Krishna mantra, anywhere, but in Krishna mantra and this Maha mantra, then what should be? Oh, doing pranam and by heart. And moreover, if very important. And if anyone is initiated, having diksha, doing bhajan 24 hours, remembering the sweet pastimes of 24 hours divided into 8, Ashtakadhyaya, and serving Radha Krishna Kanjuga in the guidance of Gaur Nityan. No criticism to anyone. He never criticizes him. If anyone may criticize him, but never he criticizes. And a speciality is there. Dena Gabi Sunni Chena Karo Rabi Sahi Sunna Aina Madadena Kirtaninya Sadari. And if he has practiced this for for what? Mahaprabhu's teaching. Dena Gabi Sunni Chena. Even
more humble than a bed of grass.
Praise of course. He's more tolerant here than a tree. A tree has everything for others, not for him. His fruits, flowers, honey, leaves, branches, his wood, his shade, everything. Even a person or taking some
stone,
a stone and he is dying by water, no water. He is so much thirsty, but even he will not ask anyone that, oh, please, and then I will give him. Even a tree cutter will come and he wants to cut. But for him, he will give his shape, his throat, everything. So we must be tolerant and free, even respect. Vaishnava, mm-hmm. not only Vaishnava, if revered Krishna is there, in all atoms, in all animals, in all grasses, what should we be doing? God, my dear Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, everybody, what to tell Vaishnava? So, Vrindadi Sunna, that don't criticize anybody, even who is able to be criticized, even they never criticize. So we should be right. And then what should we do? We should give our heart and soul in a lot of faith and always try to serve Him by all senses. By all way, by all means to Him. Then, what will be? Then Krishna Bhakti will come. Krishna Bhakti is a personality, not only mood. Understand? Srimati Radhika is mood of Krishna. So she has said, she has qualities, she has everything so beautiful. So this bhakti is also, what is bhakti? Radhika, Radhini Shakti and Sambit Shakti, essence of both. And where it is? In Radhika. So that bhakti comes from Radhika. So you must, that bhakti will come if she will see that, oh, he is now qualified. He is proper respecting all Vaishnavas. Then bhakti. Otherwise, never bhakti. So we should try to follow. Yusu, how do you?
Humble.
Respecting me. Do I have no quality to be respected? And he has so many qualities. He is a Vaishnava, serving his Guru. But even he is. But I went to Los Angeles, I went to Honolulu, I went everywhere. But they closed their door.
Mm-hmm.
Who my brothers? Who my sons? That was it. Oh, Narayan Maharaj. Narayan Maharaj cannot come to see all these. And also, they told that, oh, making some resolution that any devotee should not go to see Narayan Maharaj or hear his classes. If he hears his classes, then he is no more Vaishnava. And so he should be repented. All those who will go to Narayan Maharaj, or they cannot enter in our temple, because the temple belongs to them, not to their Guru. That is that they can control. We know that any temple, anyone, even Mayavadi, even Karmi, Jnani, all can go freely there. But a Vaishnava like me, servant of Swamiji, who has served Swamiji whole life and even serving, oh, he can.
But Queen Star and Mayavadi are allowed.
Oh, I can. Actress. So, but I see, and then their God brothers here, how generous. Oh, he invited me. Oh, to come. I'm very happy to come. And to see the beauty where Radha Govind and and so many, oh, Damodar Shila and other Shila. With Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself worship Damodar Shila. Here also Bhakti Shila and also the deity which Sarvam Bhattacharya. Giriraj Maharaj, Prabhupada, all I did. And then he had to come. even being not a Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, but his only all which are connected to me. But I know that we are in one family. And what family? Gaur family. Gaur Parivar. And especially in Gaur Parivar, what name? Rupanu Guru Parivar. We should know also what is Rupanu. Only Jai will not do Rupanu Guru Parivar. No, we should know what is Rupanuga. Jadurani is here?
Yes.
What is Rupanu? Oh, in few words. You can understand the word. Perhaps we are all Rupanuga. We can explain. Now she is perhaps your senior.
Yes, yes.
Before knowing or understanding what Rupanuga Bhakti is, one needs to understand what Raganuga Bhakti is, and before that, what Ragatmika Bhakti is, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained to Sri Sanatana Goswami in Madhya Lila of Chaitanya Charitamrita. Ragatmika Bhakti is that love of the residents of Vrindavan, particularly in friendship, parental, and conjugal love, where there's so much absorption in...
Oh, carefully you see here, then you can know that what is Rupanuga, and what is Raganuga, and what is nothing.
Just as one takes a white cloth and puts it in a red dye and then wrings it out, it's somewhat red. Repeatedly doing that, it attains the same color as the dye. That's complete saturation. So full absorption in the object of love, Krishna, with an unquenchable thirst to attain him, is Ragatmika Bhakti. Those devotees who are following in the footsteps of these associates of Krishna, particularly in Vatsalya, Sakya, and conjugal love, are called Raganuga Bhaktas. And they follow in the footsteps of Ragamika Bhaktas, who come here to this world and play the roles of Raganuga Bhaktas. Just like Sri Rupa Manjari is Rupa Goswami. So he's in his siddhasarira, Rupa Manjari, but he plays the role of a Raganuga Bhakta, because we cannot follow Rupa Manjari and put on the saris and pretend to do spontaneous love. So we follow him in his sarang bhajan. Then, among Raganuga Bhaktas, there's one special category in Madhurya Lila, Madhurya Ras, or conjugal ras. There are two categories in conjugal ras. One is called Sambhogatmika, and one is called Tat-Tat-Bhava-Ichchatmika. Sambhogatmika are those gopis who directly engage in relationships with Krishna. And they are like Srimati Radhika, Lalita, Vishakha. Then there's another very special category, and that is called Tat-Tat-Bhava-Ichchatmika, which is the pinnacle of devotion for the jiva to attain. And that is the followers of Sri Rupa Manjari, who is the head of all the maid servants of Srimati Radhika. Those who are following Sri Rupa Manjari, and her next in line is Radhi Manjari, who appears in this world as Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, and all their assistant maid servants, they are called Rupanuga Bhaktas. So all Rupanuga Bhaktas are Raganuga Bhaktas, but not all Raganuga Bhaktas are Rupanuga Bhaktas. This is very special in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami. And as Srila Prabhupada gave us the pranam mantras of his Guru Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada. Madhu Joy Jula Pramaja Shri Rupa Nuga Bhakti Da. Bhakti Da means giving bhakti. And what kind of bhakti? Madhuja Ujula Prema Adya. Adya means enriched with prem. What kind of prem? Madhurja prem, conjugal love. And what kind of conjugal love? Rupa Nuga conjugal love, or the following of Sri Rupa Manjari, which is the gift, the very special gift that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to offer to the fortunate jivas. He came for two reasons, to taste the love of Srimati Radhika. Krishna wanted to taste Radhika's love, and he wanted to give the highest opportunity to the jiva, service to Srimati Radhika, and feeling all of her bhavs in their own heart. Just like if you go to a movie, you think that this heroine is me, this bad guy is my enemy. So those who are in the line of Rupa Nuga, followers of Rupa Manjari, they experience all the love that Srimati Radharani gives to Krishna and all the love that she receives from Krishna. So therefore they have no desire for any separate relationship with Krishna, because they're getting more by their identification with the emotions of Srimati Radharani. And they also get the opportunity to serve Radharani even in situations where the topmost friends of Srimati Radharani, like Lalita and Vishakha, hesitate to go. So Rupa Nuga Bhaktas, like Srila Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, have come to this world having been in the association and still being in the association of Rupa Manjari, Ratha Manjari, as their very intimate associate, and he's coming to bring us back to that service for Premanandi.
Distributing books, making so many temples, so many cow sheds, reading Bhagavata, doing archan. All are fine, but this is quite wrong. Quite wrong. Even those who are following Bhakti Goswami Sindhu, even they are not Rupanta. If they are doing Shramadam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Shramadam, Pada Shivanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Darshanam, Sakham, Atmaniti, they can do 64 limbs of Bhakti. They may do. They may be in Vrindavan, but it is not that they are all in Rupanta. They are falling like Subal, Siddham, Madhubangal, all they are falling. Some had idea that even Subal Sakha, he is also Rupanta. Because he enters sometimes in the Kunja or in serving something. Even Jasoda is not anyone falling if Jasoda Devi, Nanda Baba, or Subal Sakha, Madhu Mangal Sakha. They are falling here and they are Anub of them.
Alarm!
Someone is wrong.
Automatic.
Haribo! Car is doing kirtan.
Even in the sakhas of Nityananda Prabhu, eight sakhas, they are not rupanta. But if they are following the modes and the service what Rupmanjari is doing himself, but Rupa Goswami is meditating. But he is meditating. Oh, I am Rupa Manjari. I am signing, I am giving all these six Sambhul Vedika and other things. I am managing to meet Radha and Krishna conjugal so many services. So this seva, if anyone is following his own constitutional form, Rupa Manjari form, then he is Rupa Manjari, other than he may follow Yashoda Maiya, Nanda Baba, Subhadra Khar, even all. Even he can follow Lalita, Vishakha, they modes. They are not Rupa Manjari. They were worshipable of Rupa Manjari. Because Rupa Manjari is in the gun of Lalita and always serving Lalita and Vishakha. But even anyone following them, they will not be Rupanta. Only Rupa Manjari. Like Rupa Manjari is Anuga of Rupa. Parunata Goswami, Ji Goswami. Even Sanatana Goswami, sometimes he becomes Rupanta. He has prayed his elder brother and guru, Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami has prayed to Rupa. Oh Mahaprabhu, please give me the inspiration of all. And he has accepted like his teacher. No hurt. And other hand, Rupa Goswami thinks that he is my guru. And paying respect in the same way. Oh, we cannot understand all this. Okay. So, please try to know all the Vaishnavas who are in the line of Rupa Goswami, who are in the line of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, who are in the line of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta, and those who are in the line of my Gurudev, and all God brothers there. And they are chanting, remembering in their line, even Swamiji line, so many are. In them, no. Not all were falling down. So many sincere Vaishnavas. Even in Grihast they are. I know so many. Even they are sincere Vaishnavas. They are not falling down. But those who are not following the line of Swami, not respecting other Vaishnavas, and not doing bhajan. Actually, they were never advanced. They are even not following them, but they are not. Never they respected Gandhi Vaishnava, never they followed the line of Bhaktivedanta Swami, never, and even today. But they are, if they are ISKCON, they were ISKCON, then 95% of the sannyasi, perhaps more than that, 99, all the sannyasi has left. They are Guru there and they are making sense gratification. If they were ISKCON, then where is now that ISKCON? Really ISKCON who had been established by Krishna himself. Brahma is first Guru, second is Narad, Das, Sukadeva Goswami, and after that, Bhagavan Purika, Ishwar Purika, Mahaprabhu. All solution for realist one is this. Swami Jayashta, he has changed the name in English one. So,
should know all these facts and we should try to develop our Krishna consciousness. Those who are helping in our Krishna consciousness, they are my teacher. They are all Vaishnava. We should respect. But those who are not helping in development of our Krishna consciousness, cheaters. They are for Dharmi Kunta.
Yes, come
down. So there are so many. So we should try to be very careful and come in the real strong guidance. And we are all Krishna consciousness. So I'm giving my respect and so many thanks to
Surya Prabhu,
who invited us like our God brothers, and he gave me some time to speak on this. Go, Dhamma! Go,
Dhamma!
Push me down to Prabhu.
Jai Radhe, Jai Krishna, Jai
Vrindavan. Jai Radhe, Jai Krishna, Jai Vrindavan.
Hare Hare, Hare Rama,
Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jai Vrindavan, Jai Somasuru,
my friend.
Vrindavanavanipate,
Vrindavanavanipate,
Jayasoma Soma Mole,
Jayasoma Soma Mole,
Sanakasanandana,
Sanakasanandana,
Sanatana Naradeja,
Sanatana Naradeja,
Gopeshwara,
Gopeshwara,
Rajavilasi Yogangri Padme,
Rajavilasi Yogangri Padme,
Prema Prayacha,
Prema Prayacha,
Jirupadi Namo Namaste,
Jirupadi Namo Namaste.
You know this Gopeshwar Mahadev?
Yes.
Oh, he came from Kailash to Vrindavan to see Rasa study and to join Rasa and to see Rasa. But all the gopis in the border of Vrindavan, they checked him. Oh, you cannot enter in Vrindavan. Then he began to weep. And he prayed that, how can I go there? Then they told that you should worship Purnimasi, Yog Maya. And he may enter you, give a chance. So for thousands of years and years, he did Aradhana of Purnimasi. He became happy and he at once appeared. What? Want? Oh, please, I want that, I want to see the Rasa Leela of Krishna and Gopi. Oh, by this body you cannot see. You will have to Gopi, and it is very rare. So he took the hands of Shankar Mahadev, and he drowned in a kund, that is Brahma Kunda. And now he, when he came out, he became a gopi shape. Oh, now you can sit. So you should sit here. This very Isan kund, like a kunja. And she went, and Rasa began. When Rasa began, all gopis were telling, oh, today no so much
pleasure.
Any outsider has joined here. But who is he? They began to search. And in the last found a gopi, newly gopi. And then what? They asked her, what is your name? Who is your husband? Where you live? Who is your other thing? But he could not reply. Then it then knew, and they began to go like this. It was like swollen. And she began to weep. Then He called again Purnimasi came and he requested Krishna and Gopi to be satisfied and he became Gopishwar
Mahadev. Jai Jai Gopishwar Vrindavan Mahadev.
Jaya Krishna Sakha Matra Vimala
Yeah. That's why I got this.
Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada,
Jaya Prabhupada,
गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय पदभक्ताय Jab Kuroshi Jadarshanasi. But we should go, try to go very deep. Yat karoshi, whatever you do. What you? Shnashi, taking bath. Jyotihoshi, for sacrificing. Any tapasya, austerity. The fruits will be given to Krishna. Very good. In our life, our bhakti practitioner, whatever they do, they should give it to Krishna, offer it to Krishna. But there is some defect. Mahaprabhu told that it is bhakti. It is. Why? He told, if there is son of any father, and father left so much of wealth for his son, he is still alive, and now by his mercy, son has become the owner of all property. Should he offer anything to him? Understand what is meaning? A son should serve his father. He is not owner now. Father is owner. But mercifully he has told that, oh, you know, owner of my home. So if he brings any pant or shirt, does he tell that, oh, I am, oh father, I am offering you, donating you, this tradition, what he should say? Yes. Already, the all wealth and everything is his father's. So he should not denote him, and if denoting that, what is, okay. So you are not the owner of all any property. But we do, some devotees I have seen, even in our line, Mahaprabhu line, they do Govardhan Parikrama. And after finishing Govardhan Parikrama, they offer, donate the fruit of Govardhan Parikrama to Krishna or to Giriraj. Is this correct? Not for. For some part it is correct for beginners. That too I know. But it is wrong. That is why in Srimad Bhagavat it has been written. What written? Iti pun sarthita bhaktis chevna lakhna kriyet bhavati abdatan manne dhita. What is the meaning? What is the meaning?
This is from Sadhguru Krishna. That first, before one is performing the nine processes of bhakti, that if we put Sadhguru Krishna, that one should offer oneself to Vishnu. But here in this verse, two Vishnus are mentioned. One is Sevaka Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Servant of Godhead, who is Guru. Gurudev, and the other is Savior Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Worshipable Godhead, Krishna, Vishnu. So, iti purusapita Vishnu, first offer oneself to Sevaka Bhagavan, to Gurudev, and then, iti purusapita Vishnu, bhakti charanava lakshana, then one can perform hearing, chanting, remembering the ninefold processes of bhakti. And then Gurudev, he will purify the heart. And then Kriyata Bhagavati Adhar, and then he will offer that heart or that devotee to the divine couple Radha and Krishna. And Lord Maharaj says, Tan Mani Ditam Putama, that this is the best thing that we've learned.
Siti Punsarpita, Vishnu, he should offer himself, his all senses, body, mind, soul, everything to Krishna. That he told Krishna book to Krishna. Guru Bhagavan and Sevak Bhagavan. So first to Sevak Bhagavan. And then Bijli, he will be of Guru and Krishna. His everything is of Guru and Krishna. Nothing to offer now. Now he will serve. By Kirtan he will serve. Nothing to offer its fruit. He will do Kirtanam for Krishna. What? He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namaste Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Pranamami Hari. Oh, for Krishna, for Radhika, nothing to offer his fruits, because he is not the master of all the fruits. Like a dog, we are of Krishna. We are not the master of fruits of anything. So offer yourself first and all your activity. By that you are serving Krishna. And if you are not doing, you are not doer, you are not master of any fruit, everything is of Krishna. So don't be doer, otherwise you will be cheated. You will have to test the bad activities fruit. So don't do this. Always think that myself, my wife, my children, my wealth, reputation, everything is of Krishna. Like Pandavas, everything was Gopis, all things were. They were only serving. Otherwise they will be guilty. Devils think like opposite. What? Janami dharmam Nachame pravitti, janam madharmam, nachame nivitti. Vaya rishikesa yatha, rishikena, yatha nityoktosi tathakam, bhamana jantram aham, bhamana jantri aham, bhamana jantri aham jantram, yatha nityoktosi tathakam. Duryodhan, very clever. He is praying to Krishna. Krishna, I know all kinds of dharma, religion, what to do. But I cannot do. Why not do? It will come. And I know also what is against religion. But I am not doing so. I am always engaged in that. Oh Krishna, I am like a machine, instrument, and you are what? Operator. So what I am doing, good or bad, or you are doing actually. I am not doing anything. So if any bad activities I am doing, it is due to you and this fruit will go to you. No, nothing to you. Understand what I told? What I told Prabhu?
You are saying that Duryodhan is speaking to Krishna and he is saying that this body, that you are actually the owner, you are the operator, and this body is simply a machine, and whatever good activities you get credit for that, and whatever bad activities this body performs, you also get credit for that. You're the doer.
Okay? Understanding all? I am not responsible for that. You will have to test of our bad activities. Because you are...
Operator means...
You inspire me to do so. I am not in fault. If any fault in you... So, all the demons tell like this. They accept Dhritarashtra when Krishna sent a crew to Dhritarashtra before that war. He went and tried so much to give good suggestion. Then Akur told so many things. Oh, you are father of Kauravas and Pandavas. Oh, you should support and nurse him. And you should try to give him hope. Don't make any vows. Krishna also did not want war. Pandavas never. You should be religious. Like your father was. Like Bhisham Pitama, like others, you should try to follow your ancestors. He told, I know all things. I know. But I cannot follow. This is it. I am so much attached to my sons. I cannot make them equal to Pandavas. I know that I am doing wrong. But I cannot change my view. I will see what is going to happen. Then I will see what. And he returned. Even Krishna went to Kaurava. And he tried to make peace, but so demons like this. So we should not be like them. This will die deeply. Then comes Sarvadharma Anupasthiti. You know, this is the words of Krishna. And this is the last conclusion of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. And Krishna himself telling. What is telling? Sarva dharmano parityajya. Mame kam saranam braja. Aham tvam sarva patobhya mokshayishyami mahi. Oh, you should take my shelter. You should give up dharma. What is dharma? There are two kinds of religions, dharmas. One constitutional and eternal. And another is worldly varnashram dharma or any dharma. Varnashram dharma and the dharmas related to body and sukshma, mind, subtle body. Or so many, not only one, lakhs and lakhs. Here he is not telling for constitutional, eternal dharma. He is telling those dharmas who are related to this gross body, material body, and for what is that? Like she is my wife. And I have promised to support and nourish her for my family. Like Indian culture, not in this. So if I am giving up and taking shelter of Krishna and giving up her and serving Krishna, then what will be? I'll have to suffer. A pap sin will come to me. If I am not serving my father and mother, my sisters and brothers, we should try to support. If you are not doing and giving up and you are coming in the shelter of Krishna doing nothing, then what will be? Oh, so much sin will come and you will have to test it. Oh, you are supported by your whole samaj, society, by king in this country. Oh, air is coming from where? There is a contaminating duty of air, fire, oh, so many things, ether. So they are supporting our, all these things. Mother has this body, mother took in her home. Father gave so many things. So we are all indebted. So if you are giving up all and not doing all this, then so many sin will come. That is why Krishna is telling, sarva dharma anupatya jamami ekam saranam braja. Then sarva pape bho mukhya ishyami. If you are fearing, oh, don't fear. I will burn all the sins you have not noticed. So here, what is this? Not bhakti, not pure bhakti. Only it is a door of bhakti. Here anyone fearing from all this? And Krishna is telling him, or don't fear. I will excuse your all faults and sins. He is not telling that I will give you bhakti. I will give you prema. I will give you anything. Oh, you know, bhakti revainam gayati. Bhakti darshayati. Bhakti pusha. Bhakti rev. Only bhakti can take. Not any other activities. If you are giving up all things, even your sins and everything, but you are not serving Krishna, there is no bhakti. So, Mahaprabhu is telling you. Krishna is telling Raya Ramana. Mahaprabhu is telling you. That, oh, you are bhajya. So we should neglect also this and try to go ahead. Raghunath Das Goswami has told, na dharmam, na dharmam, sutakunya nirattam klekaru, braje radha krishna paricharya, sachi sunum, nandi patisutatve guru varam, mukunda prishtatve varapara. Na dharmam. Oh, don't. Do dharma. Even adharma. Radha Krishna Prachur. Always Prachur. Sufficient. Serving of Krishna. Chant to serve Krishna. In remembering what? Serving Krishna. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Padasemanam, Archanam, Varnam. All these. Even if you are brooming in temple, what is this? Brahman from whom? Gopi. You take an example of gopis. What gopis are doing? They are grooming. They are milking. They are charding. Oh, they are clearing their houses. They are giving their sons on this way, and but how? Always remember Krishna. Govinda Dhamo
Dharmarve Ki, Govinda Dhamo Dharmarve Ki, Govinda Dhamo Dharmarve Ki, Govinda Dhamo.
Oh, their mind is where? Their heart is where? Remembering and singing this. Govinda Dhamo
Dharmarve Ki, Govinda Dhamo Dharmarve Ki.
That chanting, yoga. And what time?
Govinda Dhamo Dharmarve Ki, Govinda
fingers on the string and oh, and doing like this. What? Observe things. Someone, his son is not sleeping and he wants to sleep. Then they can keep eating in palanko and do. Govinda Dhamo Dharamana Devi, Govinda Dhamo Dharamana Devi. Anyone is going in his car, to his business. Oh, he will do like Govinda Dharamana Devi, Govinda Dharamana Devi. But work is very easy. But we have no taste. Very easy. Anyone ask me, oh, what should I do when you will go away from here and you will go to India? What should I do? Are you to do what?
Govinda Dhamo Dharamana Devi, Govinda Dhamo Dharamana Devi.
His husband is coming. Oh, you should do this and that. Then she will reply.
Govinda Dhamo Dharamana Devi, Govinda Dhamo Dharamana Devi.
So in all, so try to follow. And then what Prabhu is telling? Oh, what Krishna told in Gita? In Kantu. Oh, it is extra. Even he is rejected Gita. Because some karma is there, mixture. They have some fear of sin and anonymity. This is karma mixture. And then Ramananda was told to, oh, you should progress. Then he told, Gyan Mishra Bhakti Shadrasar. Gyan Mishra Bhakti. What is Gyan Mishra Bhakti? Gyan Mishra Bhakti, that he is telling what? Meaning?
Ramananda Rai continued, according to Bhagavad Gita, one who is thus transcendentally situated at once realizes the Supreme Brahman and becomes fully joyful. He never laments nor desires to have anything. He is equally disposed to every living entity. In that state, Brahmabhuta, he attains Parabhakti, pure devotional service unto me.
In the Parpar?
In Bhagavad Gita, it is said that a person who accepts the theory of monism, being always engaged in empirical philosophical discussions about life, becomes joyful and is relieved from all material lamentation and hankering. At that stage, one is equipoised. He sees all living entities as spiritual beings. After attaining this elevated stage, one can attain pure devotional service. The conclusion is that devotional service mixed with ritualistic fruitive activity is, that's karma mishra bhakti, is inferior to spiritual service which is based on empirical philosophical discussion, jnana mishra bhakti.
So here Mahaprabhu is telling Chaitanya Charitamrita. It has been called Eta Sabacharya Varnashama Dharma Akinchan Hayaloy Krishna Rasha. দীক্ষা কালে ভক্ত করে আত্মসমর্পণ, সেই কালে কৃষ্ণ করে তারে আত্মসমর্পণ। ক্যান ইউ এক্সপ্লেইন ইউ?
হ্যাঁ,
এত সব ছাড়ি আর পড়ার সব।
After hearing this, the Lord as usual rejected it, considering the Jnana Mishra Bhakti to be external. He again asked Brahmananda Rai to speak further, and Brahmananda Rai replied, pure devotional service without any touch of speculative knowledge. That is called Jnana Shunya Bhakti. This is the essence of perfection.
Here it has been told. Brahma Bhuta Prasanna No Sochati No Kamsa Shama Sarvesh Bhuteshu Mad Bhakti Lavate Brahma Bhuta. So, who realizes Brahma? But Brahma is immortal, so much powerful, everywhere. So those who are realizing, they don't fear for death, any problem, always happy, always happy. If you are attached to worldly things, you cannot be happy. You are so much attached to worldly things, or in your last days you will remember and you will be ashamed. If a man is so much attached to his dog, so much attached, always kissing, always crushing, always attached, then he must be a dog in his next time. He must be. And the dog will be what? Master. And he will make his tool in his master.
Left.
So don't try to be, or use God and dog. Just opposite. D-O-G-G-O-D. So try to love God and try to be attached to Krishna, not to dogs. After some time, dog will die. Then what will do? What will you do? So try to serve and to attach to Krishna, not to any dog or anything. Here, Brahma Bhutaha, those who are like Brahma, they are not attached to anything, what is it? Always happy. They are not also attached to any pap or punya or anything. But they are of two kinds. These Brahma-bhuta devotees are of two kinds. Brahma-jnani. No? Brahma-jnani, what is the meaning? They have knowledge of Brahma. And they think we are Brahma. And another kind of Brahma-jnani, they are also Brahma-jnani, they want mukti from this world. And they want to mix in Brahma. They also. But different is this, first making some offenses in the lotus feet of Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam and all of that. Yes, that. They don't believe in Krishna that he was Supreme Personality. Oh, Brahma is something higher than me. He was a part of Brahma, covered with Maya. So, they will do like this. They never chant Krishna. What they do? Am Brahmasmi, Sarvam Khalavidam Brahma, Prajnanam Brahma, Nyaji, Sarvam Khalidam. They will do all this. Practice this. But they never attach to anyone. Always happy. But even doing offense in the lotus feet of Krishna, name, Vaishnava, Brahman and Dham, they will not be successful in mukti. Never. They are offenders, they will go to hell. And second type of Brahmavid are Brahmagyani. of Vrindavan, both are of Haridwar and Kashi, offenders. And in Vrindavan, oh, they read Bhagavatam. And they chant Hare Krishna, oh, whole day and night, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And they are happy. Why? Oh, by this chanting name and reading Bhagavatam, oh, that mukti will be available very easily. They also want mukti, like first type. But they don't chant, remember, reading Bhagavatam, anything. And they say, first wala, that it is all bogus. So they are offended. And second, they also want mukti. But by easy method, one, by chanting, remembering, by hearing, being in dham, that mukti will be available. So among these, second class of Brahmvijnani, what? Bhakti param. They will attain bhakti param, parabhakti. Parabhakti means prem bhakti. They will. And first class of first
type,
oh, where they will go?
Hell.
They are offenders. Understand? You, Shyam Rani? What I told? But listen me and then. What will become of the second? They will chant, remember, they will read Srimad Bhagavatam, they will glorify Krishna, but they will, by doing so, we will very easily enter. Not offender. So their bhakti will like what? There is heap of mustard seed. Mustard seeds are of two kinds, some yellow and some black, you know, some yellow and some black. There was a very big heap of sarso seed, mustard seed, or yellow wala. And in that heap, there was some golden, anything round, not white. Like same as yellow seed. Both are same, like from externally, you cannot find in the heap of that mustard seed, and you cannot search that because all are same. But when you will put fire in that heap of mustard, what will be? All mustard seed will be finished and then into ashes. And a wind will come and all will fire. And what will be there? Only that golden, oh, like seed will be there. So this is, by chanting their names, because they are not offenders, and hearing Srimad Bhagavat, their all activities, even Brahmagyan will bud. And only that seed that they are chanting, remembering, oh, the fruit will be there. And this will be very strong, and it will take him to
the second type is an offender, not only the first type.
Yes.
The second that, one is, he is saddened, but he is thinking the goal is mukti.
And it will be when he is reading Bhagavatam. And in his class, anyhow, a high class of Vaishnava came. And he began to recite Bhagavatam. And he began to hear. By hearing, by his mouth, or gradually he will give up all these things and he will be high class of devotee. Then, what? Madhaktim labhate para. In the end, he will attain parabhakti prema bhakti. How? There are examples in Srimad Bhagavatam. This one, yes, but we are giving here evidence from Shastra. So, from Shastra we should come. Obhyasization, name Su. When he took birth, from birth, was detached to birth. And always he was parinishyato abhi nirgunne. He was very much attached to Nirgun Brahma. What is Nirgun? Shapeless, tasteless, without power, no quality, and he is everywhere. And I am so that Brahma. So he was so much attached to that. But what became? Oh, his father Vyasadeva was very kind. He thought, I have a son, but unluckily, unfortunately, he is Brahma Vadi, Brahma Gyan. How can I help him? Second time. Not offensive. Always he was observing Brahma Gyan. Every he realizes that I am Brahmashma. Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma, like this. But by the mercy of his father, he heard one slope, Parha Pidam Nata Parvapu. And second slope, okay, this is slope. The very beautiful shape of Krishna, playing float, a smiling peacock feather, a very yellow, his garments like thunderbolt, and with so many cowherd boys. Within cows, legs and legs cows. And what doing? Who's smiling and attracting all. When Sukhdev Goswami, he heard this slope, oh, what are the qualities? Then Sukhdev Goswami, that they be told by any messenger, that very qualified. What qualified? How? Even Putana, took very serious poison in her. And he wanted to kill, but took a shape of mother. And for this only quality, he gave him a position of mother. How be mercy. And then he at once gave up all these things, bogus Brahma Gyan and all, and he became so high class of devotee that he has told Srimad Bhagavatam. Aho Bhagyam, Nandago Prajaukusam, Janamitram, Paramarandam, Purna Brahmasham. He saw that Now, there is much difference between Brahma and his Param Brahma. His Brahma is now fruit wala, and at that time shapeless, and his soul in good shape. Chatushan also. You know about Chatushan? What your question? What is there? Why? Yes. It is right. It is absurd. No Sai Jivukti like this. But the thing that I have received, like a person like dog, when he takes so much mind and he thinks that I am monarch sometimes and he is not in his senses and he fell down in a drain where so much bad things are coming, and he said, oh, I'm monarch. I am Brahma. Like mad persons, no sense at all. So this person thinks that I am now Brahma. So like this. But in Srimad Bhagavata, everywhere it has been what? minimize. It is not good. Though you can happy, think that I am happy, but like mad persons, like internment, and also to cheat demons, demonic persons. And four kinds of mukti are somewhat better, but any bhakta does not accept, because no service of Krishna. Then Sanat Kumar, what is
Kumar went to Vaikuntha, and there they saw Lord Narayan, and they offered their obeisances to him. At that time they were Brahma bodies. They thought that the ultimate truth was impersonal, without any quality. However, when they smelled the the four Kumaras had the ability, they had mystic city perfections and transcendental knowledge, that up to the point that the Supreme Absolute Truth is impersonal, without any qualities, without any form. They were able, though, to attain darshan of Lord Narayan in Vaikuntha, and they offered their obeisances to him. When they touched his lotus feet and also smelt the aroma of the tulsi leaves which were resting on his feet, at that time, by his association, their hearts changed and they realized that the Supreme is the personality of Godhead. Then they also became Vaishnavas, and they became qualified even to glorify Srimati Radharani.
And what I told? Jnane Priyashnam, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma. Two kinds of Brahmavadis.
There are two kinds of Brahmavadis.
Brahmagyanis.
The first kind are offenders. They don't engage in any chanting or hearing about the Lord's glories. And their goal is to merge with the Supreme and become that same qualityless, odorless, formless Lord. This is an offense, just like if I appear to be glorifying you and I say, oh my dear, you are blind, dumb, lame, foolish, meaning you have no eyes, no brain, no mouth to speak. So their so-called glorification is an offense. Also, they have no interest, no belief in the personality of at all, so they don't at all chant or hear his glories. The second kind of Brahmagyani are those who have some attraction for hearing the name, about the name, form, and qualities and pastimes of the Lord from Srimad Bhagavatam, but they have a misunderstanding of the Bhagavatam due to lack of good association, and therefore their goal is to merge into the impersonal Brahman, thinking that that is the Supreme. So these people are fortunate because they have some touch, just like a child and a scientist are both touching fire. The scientist knows all the component qualities of the fire, and the child doesn't know anything. But by both touching, they both get burnt. So by touching the holy names and qualities of the Lord, even without understanding, still, it's like their full of mustard seeds, a big clump of mustard seeds, yellow mustard seeds. But because they have some touch of the Lord's name and qualities, that's like having one little grain of gold amongst all their other grains of yellow mustard seeds. If someone tries to search out that golden nugget, little piece of grain, he wouldn't be able to find it because it looks exactly like the yellow mustard seeds. If there's some air, however, some wind, and all the mustard seeds become separated, then you can single out that piece of, that tiny piece of gold. I hope this understanding is right, that that air blowing is the association of pure devotees. By hearing from him, he'll gradually understand, because the pure devotee has realization. Therefore, that realization comes to his heart. Realization means that Krishna himself, the Vladini Shakti and the Sangvit Shakti, Bhakti Shakti, is dwelling in his heart. Radha and Krishna, both together, Vladini Shakti and Sangvit Shakti, which both emanate from Swarup Shakti, Srimati Radhika, who is the source of bhakti, is living in that devotee's heart, that pure devotee's heart. He himself, when he speaks, is not considering, first I'll say this, then I'll develop the line of thinking in that way. There's a flow, a unlimited flow, like a flow of honey, of Krishna's glories and pastimes coming into his heart and living in his heart. And it's that Hari Katha, that Krishna Katha itself, not that he's controlling it, but he is controlled by it. And Krishna Katha himself is making that devotee speak. And when the faithful and honoring hearer hears that Hari Katha, then Krishna himself cleans away all obstacles to bhakti and puts the real understanding and realization of prema bhakti in his heart. So because that second type of Brahma Jnani is not an offender in the sense that he just doesn't have the right understanding, in the sense that he has some attraction for the name and pastimes, when he hears it from the lips of the pure devotee, then he understands that his material conception was a misconception and he becomes an actual Vaishnava.
Jnani prayasu tamashan manseva. जीवंत सम्मुखरितां भवदीयवासं स्थाने स्थिता सर्वांग मनोवी जे पाय तो अजित जीतो अंत
Ramananda Rai continued, Lord Brahma said, My dear Lord, those devotees who have thrown away the impersonal conception of the Absolute Truth and have therefore abandoned discussing empiric philosophical truths should hear from self-realized souls about your holy name, form, pastimes, and qualities. They should completely follow the principles of devotional service and remain free from illicit sex, gambling, intoxication, and animal slaughter, surrendering themselves fully with body, words, and mind. They can live in any ashram or social status. Indeed, you are conquered by such persons, although you are always unconquerable.
What is the purpose? Any? Not and you? You have written something. What is that? Jnane prayasam. What is meaning? You don't think that I am Brahma. Try to reject Brahma Jnana in all. You should not try for this. Also, there is a deep meaning. And what is that? Jnane prayasam utpashya. Even you should not try to always think that Krishna is Brahma. Param Brahma. He is so from personality of God. He has so much affluence. Not like this. Like Dasya Bhakta or
neutral. They do like this. So he is telling Jnani Priyasam Udbhasya. Also, you should not think that my Krishna, my beloved Krishna, my son Krishna, my friend Krishna is Supreme Personality. Try to forget this also. But in beginning, you must think that Krishna is Supreme Personality of God. But going, so some attachment comes and you have realized that I am eternal servant of Krishna and there is a very thick relation between Krishna and myself. Then reject this theory also, that Krishna is Supreme Personality. Yeah, I know. Because it has been told. But it has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam so many times. Aishwarya Shithile Nahi Mor Priti. Up to Dwarka, you can see. But once Krishna was there in Dwarka. And he has anyhow defeated Shishupal, Jarasandha and all. And he has brought Rukmini. And now in Dwarka he married with Draupadi. In great affluence, Rukmini. And there he was living very happily. One day he was in the palace of Rukmini. And see, with her, all queens, Satyabhama and all others, all were serving Krishna. Some were fanning, some were giving chamar, some something. And they were all serving Krishna in all ways. But Krishna became some grave that day. And he told, as a lamenting verse, but, alas, I am not qualified to marry you. You are a daughter of a king. Oh, so beautiful that all birds, all demigods, heaven. So you are so beautiful. And I am black. All worlds wants you to marry and anyone does not like me. Only poor or Kinchan, they can like. Otherwise not. I am not a king, but you are like a princess, the daughter of any man. You are so much qualified, you are so much equality. I am nirgun, having no quality. So I want that at once you should select any other person, qualified person, and I will take you to that person and they will marry you and you should be happy. And Rukmini heard this and at once she was trembling and in a second fell down and he was about to die. No breaths. Then Krishna became worried and he took some cotton and said that, oh, very little, very slow, but he may die at once. So Krishna became worried and he told, oh my dear beloved Rukmini, I want only joking. Not really, you are my beloved. I cannot give up you, only joking. You know, in Vrindavan I used to jog gopis or more than this. And what in return? They used to be very angry and to tell me, oh, don't come to, oh, black. You are inner black and outer black. You are black and cheaters. We don't want you. Oh, so you should not come to our graves. They used to tell like. Sometimes they rebuked me and they told to their Sakhi, Srimati, oh, don't allow, and if he is here, you should take him for. He should not come, this black person. So I thought that we are so many, with so many years here, but I never saw you in anger mood. So I wanted to test your anger mood, but I never knew that you are so soft. Otherwise I have not joked you. So I will not give up you. And he was caressing and consoling him, and he was speaking very loudly in her mind. Anyhow, she walked gradually, and then he came, she came insensitive and told, oh, actually, I'm not qualified to marry. Only worldly persons, they want to marry me. But those who are mukta, liberated, so they want you. All. You are nirgun. But what is the meaning of nirgun? Nirgata, prakita guna, jasma. Oh. Not any worldly sataraj tam gun is there. You are out of that. You have all kinds of eternal qualities. You are so much beautiful. You are merciful. You have all the qualities. If anyone suffers a little bit,